Good day. Today I'm gonna teach the lesson from Vistas, The Enemy. It is lesson 4, The Enemy, written by Pearl S. Buck. Okay, this lesson is about a Japanese patriotist who was not only a patriotist but also a very good surgeon. His name was Sadao. His father, just like any other Japanese patriotic, was very patriotic and he loved his country a lot. He taught his son right from the childhood how to love the country and how to fight for it. Sadao was sent to America because Sadao's father wanted him to become the best surgeon of the country. Sadao went to America and learned his surgeon things so well that he became a professional surgeon in the Army of Japan. Sadao fell in love with a girl called Hannah, who was also a Japanese. They both studied in the same college and they returned back and got married according to the Japanese traditions. They even had 2 children. Dr. Sadao's house was a solitary house, a lone house on a seashore. They enjoyed the sea every day by standing near the window, just like any romantic couple would do. One evening, an American soldier was washed in front of their house. The man seemed to have crawled for a few meters and then fell unconscious. Sadao and his wife, who saw someone walking in the mist and falling down, rushed towards the shore to see who it was. They were astonished to see a blonded man fell in front of them who was hardly 17 to 18 years old. They did not want to help him because at that point of time, Americans and Japanese had a war. And Sadao didn't want to do anything against his country. Over here, Sadao had been in a trouble. He wanted to leave the American and go back as a patriotic. At the same time, as a doctor, he could not see a man dying in front of his eyes. He pleaded his wife to help him out to bring him to the house. Hannah, who was reluctant but at the same time a dutiful wife, heard whatever her husband said and brought him along with his husband and placed him on the table inside the house. Now, what would they do? The servants in the house should not know about this, otherwise they would definitely go and complain to the general, who was very rude and cruel too. Over here, the soldier was bleeding very badly because he was shot at the back. He was unconscious. At the same time, his bruises showed that he was tortured a lot. Sadao asked Hannah to bring some hot water to wash him. Hannah went and called Yumi, who was a caretaker of her child. Yumi brought hot water but was astonished to see an American lying on the table. She did not want to help. She plucked her teeth and lips and she said she will not do this. Hannah, who got angry, shouted on her. But Yumi was not ready to help. Hannah, who never had washed all these things, had to wash him with a murmur on her lips. Hannah washed the soldier and found out that the soldier was really very weak. She felt sorry for him too. Sadao asked her to bring anesthesia and clean his wounds. Now Hannah, who had never seen operations, started to vomit, but she had no other go than to help her husband. She helped her husband in cleaning his wound and held the cotton with anesthesia near to the nose of the American, and Sadao started to operate over him. He removed the blood and it started to bleed even more. Hannah could not resist anymore. She went and vomited. Now, Sadao and Hannah nursed the American as far as they could. His wound was healing and he was gaining strength. Sadao and Hannah nursed the American. Now his wound was healing and he was gaining strength. But the servants were becoming restless. They did not want to work for Sadao anymore. They wanted to go. Hannah begged them, pleaded them, but they never listened. So she sent them away by paying their wages. Yumi and a gardener who had been there right from their childhood were in tears. But they could not help it because they didn't want to go against the government. They promised Sadao that they will not leak out this information and they would definitely come back to work once they hand over the American to the Japanese government. Sadao, he also promised them that once he recovers, he will be handed over. Now Hannah had bad dreams of her husband getting caught by the Japanese general who was already very cruel and rude. Hannah wanted Sadao to get rid of the American quickly. One evening, a messenger in uniform arrived. Hannah was paralyzed seeing the sight. She thought now her husband would be put behind bars for helping an American. But her fears were unfounded. Actually, the general who was sick, who always got treated by Sadao, needed his help. He had some heart problem and he knew that he had to undergo a surgery. And only Sadao could do it perfectly. Sadao, who knew this, went with a smile to the general and also told him that he has got one American in his house and he wants to hand over him. The general, who could not do anything because right now he needed Sadao for the treatment. He promised that he'll be sending some professional killers with snipers and kill the American so that no one knows about it. Sadao said okay, treated him, gave him some medicines and also told him the operation will be done quickly. When Sadao came back home, he waited and waited for the army professionals to come and take over the American. 2 days, 3 days passed by, but no one came. And the American was gradually getting stronger and stronger, but he was very, very thankful to Sadao. But Sadao never paid it any heed. Now, Sadao didn't want the American to get into trouble. He gave him a boat and told him to move away from there to a nearby island and live there for some time and go away when he sees a Korean boat which comes by. He also gave him sufficient food and water and a flashlight so that whenever he didn't have food, to ask him to flash twice. And whenever in trouble, flash once. Sadao even advised him not to lit any fire over there and eat the raw fish in the sea. He sent American away and went to the general to perform the operation. Before the operation, Sadao told him that the American had escaped and the general felt sorry about it because he had forgotten his promise. The general said, "Do not worry, Sadao, let him go. No one knows about him coming to your house. And even if we see him, we'll shoot him dead." Now, Sadao was much more happier because he had saved a life, at the same time saved his own family. All his servants came back and his routine life started over, all over again. This story actually tells that Sadao, though he had a dilemma whether to be a patriotic or a surgeon, he actually proved to be a patriotic by informing about the American. At the same time, saved the life like a good doctor. Thank you. Have a great day.